problems are symptoms of the total system of racism, white supremacy. But that is consistently being denied. And so Donald Sterling, I'm sure he doesn't, you know, he doesn't know he made more than a multi-billion dollar offering to black people.
Right.
With his statements and the truth of what it is that he didn't know was spilling out of his mouth.
Right.
But there it is on record. And so you have the media, all the people, the white people in the media are scuffling around and calling him a racist, but they themselves refuse to talk about racism.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And so yeah. This was a gift. And so black people all over this area of the world and all over the world should start talking and consistently talk about, no matter how the court proceedings work out.
Absolutely.
The Sterling Silver Siviano revelation. The major dynamic in this area of the world is the denial of racism.
Yes.
Do you see? And so the media denies it. White people deny it. Many black people deny that, you know, why do we have to talk about racism? Racism
right.
is not a problem anymore. And
yes.
just like you said, it keeps popping up because truth crushed to earth
mm-hmm.
will always rise.
Yes.
Because it is reality. Truth is reality. Reality is truth. And so these events keep coming up. In spite of all the effort, you know, it's like a big elephant under the rug, and no matter how many people try to crush and keep the elephant from stirring, the rug continues to rumple.
Right.
And so I say this was a profound truth offering, a really profound truth offering, because it was a continuous statement of racism, white supremacy, at the same time, the denial that this is what I am. This is a wonderful offering, meaning that truth, even though you might find the truth uncomfortable, but truth is always a greater benefit than the denial or the pretense that something doesn't exist. If you can confront truth, and I say that truth, to be able to look at truth, is also a measure of self-respect.
Yes.
Do you see, no matter how difficult it is, the willingness to look at it means that you are achieving a higher level of respect for self. And I say self-respect is more powerful than a nuclear weapon. This is also the missing ingredient.
Okay.
Because for a group of people, the people who structured the system of racism, white supremacy, local, national, global,
mm-hmm.
one of the critical things that was essential, because that people who classify themselves as white are a tiny minority of the people on this planet.
Right.
Fewer than one-tenth. The vast majority of the people are black, brown, red, and yellow. And so when the people who classify themselves as white begin to come out of Europe and circumnavigate the planet, and they found that the majority of people were people of color, and when the men, white men, had sexual relations with the women of color, they realized that all the children looked like their mothers, that white could be genetically annihilated, even though they didn't talk in genetic terms, but they could see that white disappears. And so their whole effort for the past 500 years has been the effort for white genetic survival, even though they can call it by different names. They can call it imperialism. They can call it capitalism. They can call it colonialism. They can give different names to it.
Right.
But bottom line It is a total system, and this is what Neely Fuller has helped us understand from the time he laid out that racism is white supremacy. There's no other racism. There could be people of color with attitudes, but racism is a power structure and a power dynamic that operates in economics, education, entertainment, labor, law, politics, religion, sex, and war. Mm-hmm. And so from the time they recognized that they were a tiny minority that could disappear, genetically disappear, in the sea of the global non-white majority, they have this system in operation. And essential to the operation was the destruction of the self-respect for people of color, and of black people in particular, because black has the greatest genetic potential to cause white genetic annihilation. And so that's why all people of color learn, if you're black, get back, brown, stick around, yellow, mellow, white, right. That's the color code for white genetic survival. And so, you know, people think, oh, no, that just, you know, they just think that it's the darker color. It's not just the darker color. The darker color has the most powerful genetic potential to cause white genetic annihilation, and it's all the same pigment, but the people who have the greatest genetic potential to produce the highest quantity, and they appear as the darkest people. They are the people that are most feared, and therefore want to put most color behind everything else. And see, the sterling, the sterling silver Siviano affair brought out so much of this.
Yes.
It brought out a man who classifies himself as white talking about being jealous of black men.
Yes.
It
yes.
brought out V. Siviano talking, you know, or was Sterling talking about how she hated her color and she wanted to be white and that she used bleaching cream and that of all of her siblings, they were all Hispanic, but she was Hispanic and black.
Yes.
Now, all of this came out of this man's mouth, including bringing in people into the locker room of the Clippers when the black men would be half-dressed. And he would tell strangers, you know, just almost like a slave market, look at their beautiful bodies.
Right, right.
So all of this offering, I say it's a cosmic offering. All of this came out in the presence of black people and people who classify themselves as white. Not all black people, of course, but large numbers. See, I would dare say the majority of our group, black people, would prefer to not talk about racism.
Correct.
And this, and see, tragically, because we don't want to talk about the real cause, because, and this is why when black people would talk about racism in the, on the TV or something, and the white people would start jumping up and down talking about you're playing the race car.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Donald Sterling laid out the whole race deck.
Yes, he did.
And Mark Garagos, who was on CNN, you know, he's one of their legal analysts. Mark Garagos says he hears people talking like Donald Sterling every day and all the time. So, you see, if we were really wise, black people would get all the tapes, all the transcripts, and sit down in study groups and dare anyone to deny that racism, white supremacy is the dominant system on the planet. See, even the word America, A-M-E-R-I-C-A, contains the phrase, I am race.
Right.
See, just like the word Jesus in Ebonics is just us.
Yeah, I played that clip before you came on. Yeah. Yes,
you,
yes, you're
so
correct.
Truth, all, everything is energy.
Mm-hmm.
And so if we begin to understand everything is energy, and this is why it cannot be destroyed and why truth will always become evident. And it will just keep pushing and pushing and pushing.
Absolutely.
The energy forces will keep pushing and pushing until people come to terms with reality. And when I was trained in psychiatry over 40 years ago, they used to tell us, see, now psychiatry doesn't want to talk about reality, because then it would have to talk about racism, white supremacy.
Hmm.
And so the dominant people in the field are people who classify themselves as white. They don't want to talk about white behavior. So they are now pushing pharmacological psychiatry. In other words, any complaint, just take a pill. Certainly don't decode the system of racism, white supremacy, because you might really get well, and then the system will be in difficulty. But we were trained that years ago that the role of the psychiatrist is to help people face reality even when they are afraid to do so.
Mm.
And so we must keep trying to find the courage and the self-respect. See, people talk about spirituality. In my view, see, there is a creative force in the universe, and you can call it God, you can call it whatever you want to call it, that is responsible for making this grand and glorious universe that has some problematic people. And I say that the creative force made black people the mothers and fathers of everybody on the planet. White people couldn't produce all the colors. Black people can produce all of the colors, starting with crystal black, highest level of black. Then next you make a mutation to albinism, and that's what white people are. They're a mutation, a genetic deficiency state. But you combine those two together, and you get all the colors in the middle.
Right.
So the creative force made black people the mothers and fathers of everybody on the planet. But under white supremacy, black people have been taught to hate black, which, as I said, came out in V. Siviano's, you know, about her, that Donald Sterling talked about how she wanted to be white. Although she did have the courage to say, I'm black and Hispanic.
Right.
You see, so how could you be hating black people? How can you say these things, right?
Absolutely.
So she had the courage to, you know, to me she gets an A+.
Absolutely.
Because her discussion was completely and totally relevant to the
mm-hmm.
reality of racism, whether she recognized it or not. So
absolutely.
This, if black people, if we can get the courage to respect ourselves, in other words, like African Liberation Day, see, liberation can come in many forms. And I say what we need is the liberation of our minds and the transformation of our minds, beginning with the understanding of this great problem on the planet, which is the system of racism, white supremacy. Do you see that? By black people learning how to respect themselves, because whatever you want to call the creative force in the universe that made us black and made the condition of crystal black, highest level black, that as long as we are in disrespect of that, we are in disrespect of the creative force.
Absolutely.
And then people want to beg and pray to the Creator, help me with this, help me with that. And I would say the Creator said, you're spitting in my eye. I made you black because black is the most critical thing on the planet. That's how come the astronomers are all talking about dark matter and the most powerful thing is the black hole. Racism, white supremacy has trained black people to hate themselves as black, to be glad that the slave masters raped our great-grandmothers, and so people don't look black and are trying to look white. And see, the system of racism pays the highest salaries to black people who, without understanding, are calling black people niggers and dogs and bitches and hoes and gangsters and thugs.
One thing's for sure. You will get called a bitch. Bitch. So motherfucking fast. Bitch. Short dogs in the house. Bitch. What's up, bitch? You the cut up, bitch. Fuck some, bitch. Suck some, bitch. Look out, bitch. Watch out, bitch. Yeah, I fucked you, bitch. Then got out, bitch. Catch out, bitch. Fuck that shit. Motherfucker getting mad. Fuck that bitch. So, bitch, pay me, bitch. You can love me, bitch. You can hate me, bitch. Straight up, bitch. Save up, bitch. Then pay up, bitch. I don't play that, bitch. Cause a bitch is known to get out of line. And a bitch don't understand. I'm on the grind, you little bitch. I'm all about the paper. When I leave, bitch, tell them all about a player gone, bitch. Come on, bitch. Run home, bitch. Get front on, bitch. That's right, bitch. Fuck off, bitch. You get off, bitch. When you suck all them dicks, get cut off, bitch. When I come on, bitch. Shit ain't right. Get the fuck on, bitch. Speak up, bitch. Say what, bitch. Wanna pull me down? I'ma stay up, bitch. So what, bitch? Do what you wanna do. A nigga like me don't want nothing from you. I want a bitch, a real ass bitch. You can feel that bitch when she feel that grip. $100 bills, bitch. I'ma still get a grip and I won't feel shit when I get a new bitch. Little bitch, back up, bitch. When I say you fire, don't act up, bitch. I slap her, bitch. Get smacked up, bitch. Wanna get in my way when I stack up chips, I call her a bitch. You know what? A bitch is a once a month funky cock bleeding. Bitch fell in love, but she won't stop cheating. Real dumb with low self-esteem. Fuck a nigga she just met and won't be able to see. Later on when she wanna get fucked some more. I said, bitch, why you such a stupid hoe? You little bitch, you never could fuck with this. And every bitch that don't like it, she can suck my dick. 20 years later, still setting it off. Still talking bad about them pregnant dogs. They ask me, short dog, why you talk so bad? Disrespect me, get off on her ass. I'm pulling whole cards, trying to learn a lesson real quick. Ask me, what's the definition of a bitch? A real bitch, she gon' know she won. Suck a dick, drink the nut and say she owe me one. Damn bitch, do that bitch, can you do that bitch? Move back bitch, say who that bitch? I don't know you hoe, I don't sniff cocaine, I don't want no blow. Bitch, you a dummy, bitch, junkie, bitch, funky, bitch, punk ass, bitch. Jump out, bitch, get the fuck out, bitch, get cussed out, bitch. Cause a bitch is known to get on my nerves. And a bitch don't really know when I'm on the swerve. I'm like, bitch, miss me, bitch, don't kiss me, bitch, just lick me, bitch. Use a bitch, knew it when I heard the beat. Bitch ain't nothing but a word to me. I told you 10 times, all she gon' get is pimp lines. I'm sure a dog, I call her a bitch. Thank you.
bitches around this motherfucker.
Bust left up here on Sunset.
All right. Yo, check it out. There's some bitches right there. You want me to pull over?
Yeah, pull over. Pull over.
All right.
Hey, yo, bitch, come here. Let me talk to you for a minute. Yeah, you. Come here, bitch.
Nah, your mama, bitch. You know what the fuck we talking about.
Get your motherfucking ass over
here. What you want,
hey, what's
big
up?
Boy?
What's up?
What you mean, what's up? What kind of money you talking about?
Money.
What kind of money you talking about? Black ass will keep on walking. Now, what's up, baby?
Dick, bitch. Grab that bitch. Grab that bitch. Grab that bitch. Grab that bitch.
Fuck that motherfucker.
Fuck it.
Fuck
it.
Fuck your motherfucker.
I'm fucking this bitch. Fuck this bitch, man.
What's wrong with you, man? Shoot this bitch in my shit.
I shouldn't have put the bitch in the goddamn car anyway.
Fuck that bitch, man. Throw the motherfucking ass out. Yo, there goes some more bitches over there. Blow the motherfucking horn.
The world's most dangerous group. Once again, beating on your motherfucking eardrum. Doing much damage for all you slutty ass hoes. Yo, there was a bitch I knew on the avenue. She was with a G.O. for another two. Yo, I think her name was Clara, and she was guaranteed to give a motherfucker whatever he needs. To be perfectly honest, she was a hooker. So I took her 100 yards to the boulevard. I told her, I'll take care of you, you take care of me. You've got a B-I-M-P, and all I want is the money. She went to work and the niggas was fiending, yo. She had the biggest ass that you ever seen. In fact, she was like Medusa, with titties full grown. Well, look in your dick, turn to stone, yeah. Keeping in mind that she was the kind that would find the time to get in mine. Because she knows I'm not to be fucked with. She ain't crazy. Fucking with Dre, she'll be pushing up daisies. She was the perfect hoe, but wouldn't you know, the bitch tried to gank me, so I had to kill her. Yeah, straight hit it. Now listen up and let me tell you how I did it. Yo, I tied her to the bed, I was thinking the worst, but yo, I had to let my niggas fuck her first. Yeah, loaded up the 44, yo, then it straight smoked the hoe, cause I'm a real nigga. But I guess she figured I was soft, but she paid the cost to the boss and got tossed. One less bitch you gotta worry about. She's out of here, and that's how it turns out. Now Vicky, 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 she's very tricky. She put a hickey on top of my dick, sick bitch. See, she told me she loved me, and she wanted to keep me. If only she could have the dick weekly. I said I'm with it, but baby, you gotta hold up. If I was happy with something that I could fold up, we could do this. She said her husband was rich. Then I knew I had the bitch, yo. She wrote a check, many a check, in the name of a bitch who was struggling at the same game. All I wanna do is get P-A-I-D, just a little something for fucking me, yo. Everything was cool, but Vicky concerned me. Her husband was the district attorney, so before he found out he was crossed up by this bitch I was fucking, I had her tossed up and put to sleep. So nigga, never forget, a dead bitch can't tell a nigga shit. One less bitch I gotta worry about. She's out of here, and that's how it turned out.
One less bitch you gotta worry about.
Motherfucking right.
One less bitch you gotta worry about.
Thinking about money and looking at a prostitute. The bitch was cute, so now I gotta execute and shoot game like a real nigga with a steel trigger. Convince her to move up to something bigger. I think I had a flashback though, cause I said fuck it, low. Choked and spoke to the hoe like this. Bitch, it's all about Dre. The money, 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 and that's all I gotta say. Of course she came with me and remained with me. But the bitch felt lame and ashamed to be working that trick shit. Cause niggas knew that she was show one. A little later though, she caught one in the chest, and I knew that it was coming. By who and how the whole act would be done. So what? One less bitch you gotta worry about. But that ain't how it turned out. Yo, there was a bitch named Renata that shot her. Straight pulled the motherfucking trigger and said I got her. But I had better plans to give her the blues, like dumping her in the river with cement shoes. I knew my money was coming up short in the vault, but the stupid bitch thought she'd never get caught. Came home early and straight bust her ass on the couch with her other nigga counting my cash. I should've knew she was like them other hoes. I told them two motherfuckers to take off their clothes. Butt naked, nothing left but the shoes. I had up the 9, so they couldn't refuse. I shot the nigga, he was out of there, and tied up the bitch to the motherfucking chair. Now there's one less bitch I gotta worry about. Everybody out, that's how it turns out.
One less bitch you gotta worry about.
In reality,
one
A fool is one who believes that all women are ladies. A nigga's one who believes that all ladies are bitches, and all bitches are created equal. To me, all bitches are the same. Money hungry, scandalous, groupie hoes that's always riding on a nigga's dick. Always in a nigga's pocket. And when a nigga runs out of money, the bitch is gone in the wind. To me, all bitches ain't shit.
See, that's the complete annihilation of black self-respect. And people think it's entertainment.
Correct.
No, that's the system of racism, white supremacy. You know, it's no different than racism, white supremacy said, I will not give you jobs. I will not give you significant employment. I will not give you education. I will not give you housing, but I will give you guns. And I will give you drugs.
Right.
And so right. Then you can destroy yourselves based on my motivation. Racism, white supremacy is the local and global power system and dynamic, structured and maintained by persons who classify themselves as white, whether consciously or subconsciously determined, which consists of patterns of perception, logic, symbol formation, thought, speech, action, and emotional response, as conducted simultaneously in all areas of people activity, economics, education, entertainment, labor, law, politics, religion, sex, and war, for the ultimate purpose of white genetic survival and to prevent white genetic annihilation on planet Earth, a planet upon which the vast and overwhelming majority of people are classified as non-white, black, brown, red, and yellow by white-skinned people. And all of the non-white people are genetically dominant in terms of skin coloration compared to the genetic recessive white-skinned people. So the dynamic of racism has to destroy black people for the purpose of white genetic survival. And that's right. Genocide. And I say that is what is happening to black people. In other words, the destruction, and it's the tactic or the strategy is the destruction of black men. And if you destroy the men of a people, you will have destroyed the people. And we are watching and seeing this, the incarceration of black men, black males dropping out of school, fathers, husbands not in the home, because men have to have employment to function as husbands and fathers. And right. So if there's high-level unemployment, then you are making necessary for people to try to find other means to bring in income or make money, and then you set up the law so that in their doing that so-called illegal activity, they can go to jail. You can remove them from the community. So we are on a genocide slide within the system of racism, white supremacy, a system for white genetic survival. So if indeed this dynamic is going on, and everything that black people complain about are the symptoms of this dynamic, and so if people are refusing to talk about it, then even though they think they like black people, even though black people think they like black people, but if you're refusing to talk about the thing that is killing black people, then we have to say that you hate black people, whether you understand it or not.
Right, right.
You see, it's like, let's say as a physician, if I know that, let's say, a certain food product has poison in it, but I say I really want to protect my reputation, and I want to be looked upon as being responsible. So I don't tell people. And so then people eat the food product and die. Can you say Francis Welsing loves the people or hates the people?
Yeah, hates the people. Doesn't love them.
He fails to tell the people about something that will injure and destroy and kill them.
Right.
See, racism, white supremacy is the highest form of terrorism and injustice that has ever been conceived on the planet. Racism as white supremacy, because it's a tiny number of people that is genetic recessive that has decided it has to survive by any means necessary, and that is by the destruction of people of color.
With white supremacy and racism itself, are they one in the same, or are they two different entities?
The same thing. Racism is white supremacy, and white supremacy is racism. There's no other racism. In other words, let's say that if I stood on the street and called people who classify themselves as white every conceivable name, that, you know, that's just Cress Welsing just talking. She cannot control whether people who classify themselves as white have housing, have clothing, have shelter, have jobs, have hospitals, schools, etc. So that's just somebody talking. They don't have any power over the lives of people who classify themselves as white. And so this is what is essential. That's why I bothered to develop a definition of what racism, white supremacy is. It's the system structure for white genetic survival. It's the system structure for the power equation of white power over a relative non-white powerlessness. See, it's like if you are going to play chess, you have to first understand the game. If you're going to play checkers, you have to understand the game. And we have not understood the game. In other words, when we were in formal slavery, we thought if they would just take these chains off, if they would just end this system of slavery, that everything is going to be all right. And we found out that Lincoln emancipated the enslaved African people, and then they structured laws. See, I say Reconstruction was the reconstruction of racism, white supremacy. The black people thought they were free. They thought they were emancipated. But after the chain came off, then laws were put in place so that black people could be controlled and demeaned. See, I tell people that at the point that Abraham Lincoln so-called emancipated the African people, that if everybody had been free, there was no color discrimination whatsoever. So everybody was mixing and blending. White people would disappear.
Correct. I believe that.
So if you ask white people, do you want to disappear? They want to tan, but they don't want to disappear. So that means that they have to, and this is why there's a whole long historical period where black men would be lynched and castrated for thinking about wanting to think about a white woman. Now they are using white women to control black men by saying, okay, now white women, you can have your ideal mate tall, dark, and handsome. But you are contributing to his confusion about the problem of racism, white supremacy. But that's very important that you have now been unleashed to engage in the confusion of the black man. Am I making myself clear? And simultaneously building, developing a mixed, so-called mixed race group of people where the mother is white. So the black man plus the white woman produce a child. The child is medium color, not white, but medium color. The white female tells the child, you're not black. And so then the child, what? Develops hatred of black. If it hadn't been for this black father, I could have been all white. But that becomes, that mindset can be a useful tool for the maintenance of the system of racism, white supremacy.
Okay, do black people purposely support the European white supremacy system, and if so, why do they? Is that your question, Ronnie?
Yes, because
see, I would say that the vast
denial.
Majority of black people do not understand the problem as I'm describing it.
Yes.
Do you see, in other words, this is new thought, starting with Neely Fuller, who was the first person to talk about racism, white supremacy as a total system structure. And so the vast majority of black people do not understand racism, white supremacy as a system. We can call it the miseducation of black people. Carter G. Woodson wrote about the miseducation of black people.
Mm-hmm.
And so the system of racism, white supremacy doesn't hardly wants us to use the word racism, and this is why Donald Sterling's revelations, in spite of himself, are so important. Because people don't want to talk about racism. It's like, talk about anything. Talk about homosexuality. Talk about anything other than racism, white supremacy, which is the key.
Right.
And so the attempt is made to block an understanding of racism, white supremacy as a total system structure. In addition to that, black people have been taught to hate themselves. Like,
that's
if
right.
I develop three pills, the first pill will turn you white the next day. The second pill will give you long, straight hair. The third pill would give you so-called white features. I would be the wealthiest person on the planet within a matter of 7 days. Because all of the people of color on the planet have been taught to hate white. This came out, as we said earlier, in the Donald Sterling dialogue about V. Subiano. He said, she said she hated being black, that she wanted to be white. Look at all
yes,
the people
right.
walking around with long, straight hair that they buy. Look at the people who are bleaching their skin. And it's not only black people, it's people in Asia, people in India. Wherever there are people of color who have been psychologically damaged by racism, white supremacy. And so black people are supporting, not only that, the system gave black people the image of God as a white man.
Thank you. I'm glad you bring that up.
This was one of the cleverest things that the system did. And this
right.
was given to us when we were in chains. And said, here, my image is God. And black people were being beaten and raped and mistreated for hundreds of years. And with the concept, well, maybe there's a white person, God in heaven, who's going to come and save me. Well, this is a deep brain-computer implant.
Yes, it is.
Jesus, if he was a historical figure in the part of the world, Middle East and Northern Africa, he could not have been white. Billy Graham even says Jesus could not have been white if he was a historic figure in that part of the world. But if you are going to hold people in oppression, first you deny them a deep level of education. So they're not reading and reading every book and searching for information and knowledge. And so you
right.
keep them in a state of non-learning. And then you tell them that the image of God, who they should be worshiping, who they should be looking to solve their problem, is the same image of the oppressor.
That's right.
So this is what has been done to us, and the challenge is for us to respect ourselves at a sufficient level so we begin to think. See, this is why the system has black people playing a lot of loud music that is sensory overload so the brain can't function.
Mm.
Just boom de boom de boom. You see? And that's supposed to be entertainment.
Yep,
but
yep.
It also cuts off effective thinking. So, you know, again, by us, you know, by black people thinking and first of all, beginning to deeply respect ourselves as black people, that this is key. Nothing without self-respect. See, self-respect was what allowed for the Civil Rights Revolution. When the black people were determined to oppose the laws of segregation, and they went up against horses and dogs, police dogs, and fire hoses, and gave their lives. Your life is not worth living, meaning if
That's
your
right.
self-respect has not reached a sufficient level. And so from that point on, then the system said, no, we can transform. See, black people came out of that movement talking about black pride, black
right.
self-respect, black dignity, black is beautiful, black power, and that had to be annihilated. And it was annihilated by telling black people they could be movie stars, but then they would be trashy images, using
yep.
drugs, cursing at one another, shooting and killing one another, and then bring it up to, you know, musical entertainment and have all kind of trashy language and black people calling themselves trashy names. So you can't be a bitch and a whore and a dog and have self-respect.
Right,
it's
exactly.
impossible. You got one brain computer, and if the brain computer is dialed towards bitch, whore, gangster, thug, freak, that's a complete annihilation of self-respect. You can get the people to do anything. And all you have to do is turn on the TV and just look. And all you have to do is turn on the TV and just look. And all you have to do is turn on the TV and just look. And all you have to do is turn on the TV and just look. You can't be a bitch and a whore and a dog and have self-respect.
Right.
It's impossible. You got one brain computer, and if the brain computer is dialed towards bitch, whore, gangster, thug, freak, that's a complete annihilation of self-respect. You can get the people to do anything. You can get the people to do anything. You can get the people to do anything. Again, if you understand the system,
mm-hmm.
and it's just like I've been saying, to hold people in oppression, you have to destroy their self-respect.
Yes, yes.
You have to destroy their self-respect.
Yes.
Which doll is the black doll? And which one is the white doll?
That one.
Which doll is the pretty doll? Which doll is the nice doll? Which doll is the bad doll? Which doll is the nice doll? And which doll is the bad doll? And why is that doll pretty?
Because she's white and he has two eyes.
Which doll is the ugly doll? Why is that doll ugly?
Because he's black.
Which doll looks most like you?
Like me?
Yeah, which one looks like you?
And that one.
Okay.
That doll.
And so basically, scandal is, you know, in other words, for the hundreds of years we were in formal slavery. You had the slave master with his black concubines, plural concubines.
Yes.
This is Thomas Jefferson and Sally Hemings. But what has happened is that the system has gone so far in the destruction of black men so that 70% of the black households are single parent, unmarried, women don't have men. Do you see? And so women, it's the nature of women to want to have a man with power, a protector. And that is what is missing from the lives of black women in the system of racism, white supremacy, because the man has been destroyed. And it's essential to destroy the black man because he is the threat to white genetic survival. And
right.
So what do we see being pushed? Black men, you want to be gay, you want to be homosexual. This is not to put down the person who says they're gay.
Right.
This is not homosexual bashing because medicine doesn't even have the answers as to why we're seeing an epidemic in the effeminization of black men. But I say it also has to do with the removal of large numbers of men and incarcerating them. Not only if you incarcerate them for prolonged periods of time, large numbers begin to have sex with each other.
Yes.
That's understood. Do you see? But all of it is a part of the symphony of the destruction of black people. Do you see? So the biggest thing in the news next to Sterling, Donald Sterling and his revelations was what? A gigantic, tall black man, football player.
Yes.
Embracing and kissing a white man.
I was about to ask that question, yes.
Do you see what I'm saying? In other words, pieces of the puzzle.
Mm-hmm.
of white genetic survival and the things that have to be done to the black collective, male and female. Do you see? So, I mean, it's got to be painful to our ancestors.
Mm-hmm.
If they're looking down and seeing black women worshiping, being the concubine for a white man.
Right, right. Willingly.
They're glorifying in it. Do you see? But again, to the extent that racism, white supremacy is not understood. Somebody, I got a call from somebody because I was criticizing Scandal, and they said, you're just jealous. God bless. Do you understand? I mean, but it really is. It's just our absence of understanding. It's just like I looked at a black man, I'm driving, looking at a black man crossing the street, and he had his pants down but almost below his buttocks.
Mm-hmm.
This is a grown black man.
Mm-hmm.
Where people don't even understand what that means.
Mm-hmm.
I say that comes from father hunger and really wanting to have male substance injected into the rectum, if not the mouth.
Mm-hmm. Is that dealing with prison culture at all? Because from my understanding,
yes, all of it is tied. But in other words, see, it's like if your body is deficient in vitamin A.
Okay.
It might occur to your brain, I need to get some greens. I need to go buy some greens. See, greens have vitamin A.
Okay.
So your brain will guide you. You know, when you think, okay, let me go and get some greens, you're not thinking, I'm deficient in vitamin A. My body is telling my brain to go and get food substance that has vitamin A. So we have the tragedy under white supremacy of black male masculine deficiency because fathers have been taken out of the home.
Right.
Males grow up just looking at their mothers put on earrings, fix their hair, but father absence. And so male children, I've had male children say, you know, parent will bring the child to the psychiatrist and say he won't study or he won't do his homework. And to have a little child, 10 years old, tell the doctor, Dr. Welsing, I think I could do my homework if I just had an official father.
Wow. Wow.
Do you see, or another child say, if I had a father, Dr. Welsing, he at least could explain to me what goes on under the hood of a car.
Hmm.
See, that makes me as a psychiatrist want to fall on the floor and cry.
Wow.
You see, because the children are feeling the pain of the attack, and we are not yet in sufficient number understanding the attack, or we are wanting. Do you see, it's like Scandal is a variation on the theme of black women going to church and wanting Jesus, white man, to love. I said black women going to church and wanting Jesus to love them, white male.
Okay.
Do you see, which is what Scandal is all about? Love me.
Okay,
white
right.
White male who has power.
Right.
While a black man is thinking, you know, just listen to, look at all the basketball players and the football players. And the rap star, I have to have a white woman.
Okay.
See what I'm saying? In other words, it's just what has happened to us, black men, black women, under the system of racism, white supremacy. It's like if we are able to lay all of this information out,
mm-hmm.
It's like drawing a circle, and the circle represents the system of racism, white supremacy. It's like the edge that... and the straight edge pieces of a puzzle. And so then you begin to see where all of the pieces fit.
Next.